In this video, we are going to be looking at solving simultaneous equations using elimination method. And I think the best way to explain this, as always, is to take an example. A plus 2b equals to 2, a minus 3b equals to minus 1. Now remember, the first thing you want to do is to label the equation 2. Now we are going to take this step by step. Now this first example is what you do when you have a variable in equation 1 and equation 2 with equal coefficients. Now if you look at this, what's the coefficient of a1? What's the coefficient of a1? So the coefficient are the same. Now this is the simplest type of equation under elimination. Now the next thing I want you to notice is that they are both of the same sign. So this is plus 1 and plus 1. So if the variables are of the same sign and they have equal coefficients, all you need to do is just to subtract the equation. You are saying either equation 2 minus equation 1 or equation 1 minus equation 2. So if they have the same sign, you subtract. If they have different sign, you add. So we are going to take an example where they have different sign. But if they have the same sign, you subtract. Now let's do this so you understand very well what I mean. So let's solve this equation. Remember, they have the same sign, so we can subtract. Now if we subtract, we'll be having a minus a, which is 0. So a cancels a minus a is 0. Can you see? That is why we are subtracting, so that we can eliminate one variable. Now this would be plus 2b minus minus 3b. Do you understand that? Plus 2b, so you can write it somewhere. Plus 2b, then we have minus, then we have another minus, so we have to put it in bracket, 3b. Now this would be 2b minus times minus is plus, so 2b plus 3b. Remember, 2b is the same thing as plus 2b. So we have 5b equals to, so here we have 2 minus minus 1. So remember, just do it somewhere rough. So we have 2 minus, then we have minus 1. So this will be 2 minus times minus is plus, so 2 plus 1. That will give us 3. So 5b equals 3. So find b, you divide both sides by 5. So we have 5 here, 1, 5 here, 1. We are left with b. So b equals 3 over 5. Do you understand? Now to find a, you put b as 3 over 5 in either equation 1 or equation 2. So let's do that. Put b equals to 3 over 5 in equation, let's say 1. And remember, I told you after writing that you have to put the equation first, or write the equation first. So the equation is a plus 2b equals to 2. So anywhere we see b, we call it 3 over 5. Let's solve the remaining here. So I'll be having a plus 2 into bracket 3 over 5 equals 2. A plus, bracket means times, so 2 times 3 is 6. So I have 6 over 5 equals 2. Now I collect like times. Number, we have to go and meet number. So a equals to 2. When 6 over 5 crosses the equal to sign, it becomes minus 6 over 5. Now we find the LCM. A equals LCM of 5 and 1 is 5. 5 divided by 1 is 5. 5 times 2 is 10. Minus 5 divided by 5 is 1. 1 times 6 is 6. So we have A equals to 10 minus 6 all over 5. Let me rub up somewhere here so we complete it. So it means that we have A equals to 10 minus 6 is 4. 4 all over 5. Which implies that A equals to 4 over 5, comma B equals 3 over 5. Do you understand this? Let's take another example. 2b minus 5c equals minus 8. 7b plus 5c equals minus 10. Now remember, the first thing you want to do is to label the equations, equation 1 and equation 2. Now the next thing you want to do is to see if there is any variable with the same coefficient. Now if you look at C, we have the same coefficient, 5, 5. The only difference is that they have different signs. So we can just add or subtract. Now because they have different signs, you add. Now when they have different signs, we add. When they have the same sign, we subtract. Now can we add this? Now if we add, we have 2b plus 7b, that will give me 9b. Now this will be minus 5c plus 5c. You can do it somewhere so you are sure of it. Minus 5c plus 5c, that will give you minus 5c. Plus times plus is plus, so minus 5c plus 5c will give you 0. Do you see why we are adding, not subtracting? If we have subtracted, we'll be having minus 5c minus plus 5c. Then this will be minus 5c. Minus times plus is minus, so it will be minus 5c minus 5c, which will give me minus 10c. Can you see that we did not eliminate anything? We'll be having minus 10c here, and that is why we are adding when we have different sign, not subtracting. I hope you understand this. So we have 9b equals to minus 8 plus minus 10. So let me do it here. Minus 8 plus minus 10. So I'll be having minus 8. Plus times minus is minus. Minus 8 minus 10 will give me minus 18. To find b, we divide both sides by 9. 9 here 1, 9 here 1. So we are left with b equals 9 here 1, 9 here 2, minus 2. So to find C, we put B equals to minus 2 in any of the equation. So I'll choose equation 1 because equation 1 looks simpler. So write the equation first, 2B minus 5C equals minus 8. Anywhere I see B, I call it minus 2. So I'll be having 2 into bracket minus 2. Minus 5c equals minus 8. Let's do the remaining by the side here. So we have 2 times minus 2 will give us minus 4. Minus 5c equals to minus 8. Collect like times, so we are left with minus 5c. Minus 4 goes to the other side, we'll be having minus 8 plus 4. So we are having minus 5c equals to minus 8 plus 4 will give us minus 4. Then we divide both sides by minus 5. Minus cancel minus. 5 here 1. 5 here 1. We are left with C equals to minus 4 over minus 5. And remember, minus can cancel minus. So we'll be having C equals to 4 over 5. Which means that B equals to minus 2, C equals to 4 over 5. I hope you understand this. Now don't forget, when they have the same coefficients, if the signs are the same, you subtract. If the signs are different, you add. Is that clear?